Namaste. Welcome back to Ma Gurukul. I hope you did try out the first activity for attention which we posted yesterday. I did get two feedbacks from my close friends that they have tried with their children and it has tried or rather it has helped them out in a little manner. Right, but then they also had these ones that what size of the bowl should be taken. So remember, whenever you take the size of the bowl or a square bowl or rectangular bowl, an oval bowl, you make sure that the child's hand gets inside the bowl or into the bucket or into the tub. If the child's hand is not getting completely into the bucket or the tub, then it will hinder the child's movement. Alright, so just keeping that in mind, you can choose whatever option is available in the house. Today's activity, again, we will be doing the activity based on hand and eye coordination and attention. Right, so I am just increasing one more today along with you. Yes, so today I told you that we will be doing an activity based on hand and eye coordination, also which involves attention. Right, so what is that which you will need today to do? Simple, any paper. It can be your child's notebook, a four line book, a math notebook where the sheet is empty, right, or a plain sheet like this, or a drawing book, wherever, I mean anything which is available along with you, and the bindis which is available in your house, right, any size and shape of the bindi. Alright, so now what are we gonna do with these colorful bindis? I will tell you and I will show it to you. For that, you need to come closer to my table. So are we ready to see what we are supposed to do? Now remember, this activity can be done for children from 1 plus to 5 years of age. So 1 plus to 5 years of age, this activity can be done. Now what do we do? We can roughly just give a plain sheet like this to them, and if the child is say around 1 year old, take a bigger bindi, or this is a little smaller version because now I have started collecting these colorful bindis which starts for my son because he's a grown up, but then I would suggest you to go with such smaller ones. Can you see these bindis? These are actually three bindis, plain bindis, plain colored bindis, but the bigger versions. So you can go with this size, or also you can go with this size. Can you see the size difference? Right, so go for bigger bindis if your child is 1 plus year old, right, and you can reduce the size to smaller versions as and when the child is able to get a grip on the bindis. So can you see? So we start off with the biggest size, then go with the smaller version, and then okay, I will put this one here, go with the smaller version and go with the smallest version. And then you can also start off with these studded bindis. Of course, studded bindis are going to cost you a little more on the pocket, but if you don't want to go with the studded bindis, it's okay, it's all fine, you can go with the plain bindis itself. All right, now that you have come to know what bindis to choose for which age group, we will also try to do activities for them. For children who are 1 plus year old, don't give them any boundaries, but just a plain sheet of a paper which can be ruled, unruled, or whatever is available in your house. Give them that and give them the size of the bindi which you have chosen or which is available in your house. All that the child needs to do by himself or herself, I am very specific, by themselves. Please don't open up the bindi or pull out the bindi and give it into their finger. Let them try to pull out the bindi, right, pick it up and stick wherever they want, right, make their own patterns. So this is the activity for children who are 1 plus years old. Right, so the next one we will continue for children who are a little elder, or as and when they start getting a hold on to picking up. Initially, children trying to pick up or pulling out the bindi from this itself will take some time. It's okay, give that child ample space, and what will happen is they might stick onto the bindi onto their finger and then try to stick it onto the page and it will not stick. right? So they will have to pull it out again and then stick it onto the page. They might use two hands at the initial stages. Please let the children do it. Let them make as many mistakes as possible and learn from their own mistakes. Kindly, I request all of you to not give them instructions continuously. No, this is the way to pick the bindi, this is the way to stick the bindi. Please don't give continuous instructions to them. Give them their space to explore, to experiment, and also to find out a way for themselves to do the things better. Alright, so now moving on, what we do next is we just draw or start giving them boundaries. Alright, so I draw a big circle. Once a child gets a grip on putting onto the bindi wherever it is possible, and the same activity will continue. But the difference is that you have given a boundary, and this needs to be spatially arranged in that particular boundary. Now, what do I mean by spatial arrangement? I don't know if all of you have observed. If I have to write, say, cat, then I have to write C, A, and T, right? So I need to space the alphabets in such a way that it is visible to you and it is readable, right? There are children who will write cat as something like this, right? So very, very close and joined. Of course, when they start writing cursive letters, it will come up, but then when they start writing cursive letters, it will be something like this, right? So there is still some space in between the alphabets. To teach them this, one such activity is spacing up the bindi. So when they have a boundary, they stick it up and they try to pull out these bindis up and try to stick it. Initially, they might stick one top of the other like this. It's okay, it's all fine, let them do it. Alright, slowly they will move from sticking one top of the other to giving them space and trying to arrange them. Children who will be very good in arranging the bindis evenly inside the boundary are the ones who will have good knowledge of spatial arrangement. That meaning giving enough space between letters or alphabets while they are writing. Now, I would like to show what Kairav had done during his younger years, or when he was 3 years old or 3+ years old, the same activities which I have tried out with him, I would like to show you those. Now, my dear friends, whenever I used to get one activity done for Kairav, I used to make sure that I write the date. Now, why is this very, very essential? There is one simple trick which I follow to track my own child's development. Say on 21/3/2018, right? So today, just 2020 now. So 2 years down the lane, what was his development? This is the first time or the third time probably he's tried to do the bindi pasting. I chose one particular color, and can you see the size of the bindi? All right. Can you also observe that the bindis have been stuck one above the other? Right. So that's all fine. So let them continue to do something like this. With these activities, what they'll usually try to learn is the hand and eye coordination, the spatial arrangement between the bindis, and also concentration. Now, I would like to go on to the other one. Can you see this? Can you see the date of this? So this is on 14/4, that is almost a month after we have been continuously training him with bindi. So I gave him something like this, similar one, just small circle so that he can stick up these bindis. Of course, few of them are there exactly in the circle, few of them are there outside the circle or towards the boundary, and all of this has happened. Again, if you can see, there is a bindi which is stuck on top of the other. Let them make as many mistakes as possible and try to learn from their own mistakes. All right. So I will show you what is the improvement after a few more years. All right. Sorry, few more months. So this is on 24/2018. I modified the same one with colored bindis. Now I gave him a good circle. Can you see the difference between the spacing of the bindis? It's not as close as they were in this one, right? Can you see the difference? Yes. So slowly they will try to bring it up. Then when I give them a earbud, so can you see the spacing of them? So beautifully spaced. So this is how they will learn to space themselves up as and when they start doing these activity or this bindi sticking activity regularly. Okay. I can show you one more. So can you see this? Yes. So putting up the bindi exactly in the circle. So that is really very good. That looks very neat. Now this is when he started to scribble. So it's all out of the boundary. That's again all fine. All right. Now I have been, since I've spoken to you for very long, and this video is probably around 10 plus minutes. I usually restrict my videos to 10 minutes. So I hope you will try this out with your children. And yes, Kairav has joined me in the video because he said you didn't involve me today. So he wanted to come. Kairav, can you please keep doing your bindi pasting activity? Yeah. Now, another request, dear parents, make sure that whenever you're doing an activity, it needs to be redone. Not, I mean, in a particular manner, say probably in the morning, don't give them bindi pasting. Again in the afternoon, don't give them bindi pasting. Again in the evening, if you give them, then they'll get bored with it, right? So say for example, Monday you have done a bindi pasting activity for them. Without the child's knowledge, you will repeat it after an alternative days. That means Monday, Wednesday, Friday or something like that. You plan your timetable best according to what your child, according to your, to the timing which suits your child. Right. I hope you will like these videos and try these activities with your children. If you do like it, then please do like, share and subscribe to Maa Gurukul. Thank you.